Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video I will show you how you can develop a fish receipt system in Java by using NetBeans IDE. So let's begin. First of all, we need to create a new project. I will give the name as fish system. Now we need to create a new JFrame. Now it's time for us to design the app. First of all, I need a JLabel. I will change the font. 48 will be enough, I think. Now we need some other labels too. We need text field. User will enter its input in text field. Times New Roman font, that's why I'm changing everything to Times New Roman. Now we need a text area. Text area is the area where we have to show our output or where we will show our receipt once it will be generated. We need some button to generate receipt, reset everything, or to print receipt. Now what we have to do, we have to change the variable name of text field so we can fetch them easily. Let's define the event. Make some decoration. Let's run it to see whether it's working or not. Yeah, it's working, but we need to change the font of our area also. Make it bold and select 18. Now I want to take the current date of my system, so for that I need to create a date object. Now it's working good. This is the main thing that we need to do. We need to create a print function. So there is a print function in Java by which you can take a print out of what is written in your text area by using any printer, or you can also save it in .xps format also. It's giving error because print area will always come inside the try block, and we need to create a corresponding catch block also. Now we have done with our coding. Now let's test our software. The receipt is generated, and now my computer is not connected to any printer, that's why it's giving me the option to save this receipt in .xps format. So to save this, I have to give the name, and I will give the name as first. So our receipt is saved. Now we can print another receipt, but first take a look on the receipt that we just have generated. So this is our receipt. This receipt is saved in .xps for XPS format. You can take a print out of this receipt also, and because it's in .xps format, so you cannot make any changes in this receipt once it is generated. So that's it in this video. We will discuss some other software, so we will develop some other softwares in upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.